हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम उत्सव मेहता, रोल नंबर 20, CS 10069, सेक्शन 10। फॉर द डी आई वैलब असाइनमेंट 5 बेस्ड ऑन असेंबली डिसअसेंबली, आई हैव डिसाइडेड टू डिसअसेंबल दिस टीवी रिमोट एंड शो यू द इंटरनल कंपोनेंट्स। सो नाउ आई विल डिसअसेंबल दिस रिमोट। नाउ आई हैव सेपरेटेड द रिमोट इन 3 पार्ट्स। दिस इज अ फ्रंट केस एंड दिस इज अ बैक केस। Both the cases are made of acrylonitrile butadiene styrene plastic, ABS plastic. Now these are the buttons. This portion and the backside is made of thin rubber. Now these buttons have these conducting discs at their backside. As you can see, every button has a conducting disc. When we press the buttons, these discs protrude out and they touch a corresponding portion on this board, and which completes a circuit on the board and it generates a signal. So now, as you can see, this is the power button. When we press it, the disc at here, it touches this portion and it generates a signal that we have pressed this power button. Similarly, for this button 1, 2, 3, we have corresponding portions. This 1 for 2, for 3, for 4, for 5, for 6. Similarly, at the end, we have red, green, yellow, blue. And we have portions like this is for red, for green, for yellow, and for blue. Now, this is the circuit board of the remote. The circuit board is made up of fiberglass and it has copper wires inside it for connections, and all the components like transistor, diode, etc. are soldered on this circuit board. Now when a button is pressed, the signal is generated and it reaches this IC. This IC knows by the signal that which button was pressed. This IC has a transistor inside it which amplifies the signal and sends it to the LED. Now this TV remote is very old, so it has 16 pin IC on it, as you can see 1, 2, 8 and similarly other 8 on other side. So this is a 16 pin IC, but nowadays most of the remote have 18 pin IC. Now this is the LED. The LED is itself a transmitter which emits infrared signals that are received on the receiver on the TV. All the signals sent by this LED are binary signals, and these signals are modulated to a specific frequency so that the receiver on the TV catches only these signals and not the other ones that are present in the surroundings. This LED is powered by this circuit board and it has two connections. As you can see, one connection is here, and similarly other connection is here. These connections power the LED. Now this is the back portion of the remote. This is the space where we keep two batteries. One battery is kept here, other battery is kept here. Now this is the positive terminal of one battery and this is for negative terminal of other battery. As you can see, there are two spiral windings here. Now these two spiral windings are connected through a wire. As you can see here, this is the wire. Now this wire connects the positive terminal of one battery and the negative terminal of one battery so that the batteries are in series and the net potential difference across both the batteries is added. Similarly, the positive terminal of other battery and the negative terminal of the second battery, they are connected here. And these spiral windings, as you can see here, they are the windings that connect these terminals to the main circuit board. Now, as I told you, the spiral windings that connect the batteries to the circuit board, they are connected here. This was the first binding wiring, and this is the second wiring. And as you can see, they are connected to the circuit board from a connection here. And similarly, a connection at the back, this one. So that is how we power the circuit board. Now I will assemble this remote. So as you can see, I have assembled the remote and it looks like what it looked earlier, and all the keys can now be pressed comfortably. Thank you.